वेक्टर स्पेस क्लासिफिकेशन। इन दिस लेक्चर आई विल कंसीडर वेक्टर स्पेस टेक्स्ट क्लासिफिकेशन एंड बेसिकली रोक्यू टेक्स्ट क्लासिफिकेशन। वेक्टर इन वेक्टर स्पेस क्लासिफिकेशन वी रिप्रेजेंट द डॉक्यूमेंट एज ए वेक्टर स्पेस रिप्रेजेंटेशन मॉडल। इन वेक्टर स्पेस रिप्रेजेंटेशन मॉडल we basically represent entire document in the form of row and column. Here each row represents entire documents and each column represents words. Now in vector space representation we will do some extra thing like it we do some extra thing like we represents word and their TFI DF score. Similarly word 2 their TFI DF score, word 3 and their TFI DF score, and so on. Similarly in row 2 we will use document 2 their word, first word their TFI DF score, second word their TFI DF score, and so on. This is the traditional vector space representation. Now we'll go through some important points like training set. In earlier in document clustering, which is actually the unsupervised kind of algorithms which do not require prior information of any kind, but in classification is a supervised algorithm. Here we use some information like set of documents with their level or class. For example, here in this picture all red circles represents the document related to government. All blue circles represents the document related to science, and all black circles represents the document related to arts, and so on. This is the requirement for text classification. We initially have such kind of information. In a vector space classification, this set corresponds to a labeled set of points in the vector space. We will have a vector space like for label 1 we will have vector space with word and TFI DF representation, and so on. Now we will go through two premises. Premise 1 says that documents in the same class form a contiguous region of space, means there may be a distinct boundary from boundary which represents one class at one side and other class at other sides. Means there the premise to clear it, the documents from different class don't overlap. Means we cannot put documents represented as a blue circle in the class which represents the documents related to red circle, and so on. This is a general vector space representation. Now suppose we consider this representation. Suppose a document represented by arrow comes, then how to classify this? For this there may be several techniques, but in this Rocchio classification what we will do, we will calculate the centroid of entire document collection and check whether this document is similar to this class, whether this document is similar to this class, or whether this document is similar to this class. Here a definite boundary is depicted, and we put this document into the class which represents the documents of government type. Now the next important part is dimensionality. वी कैन रिड्यूस द हाई डायमेंशनल डेटा. एक्चुअली डायमेंशनलिटी इज़ अ मेजर प्रॉब्लम विथ डॉक्यूमेंट्स बिकॉज इन दिस काइंड ऑफ वेक्टर रिप्रेजेंटेशन देर मे बी सम डॉक्यूमेंट्स विथ वेरी हाई नंबर ऑफ वर्ड्स, सम डॉक्यूमेंट्स विथ वेरी फ्यू वर्ड्स. देन इट विल क्रिएट्स द गैप ऑफ डायमेंशनलिटी. और फॉर ए फास्ट रनिंग ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन वी नीड टू रिड्यूस द डायमेंशनलिटी ऑफ द सिस्टम. देन वी विल यूज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ प्रोजेक्शन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल यूजिंग प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ हैंडल 2D एंड 1D ग्राफ. नाउ सपोज 5 पॉइंट्स x1, x2, x3, x4 एंड x5 आर पॉइंटेड इन ए सर्कल. नाउ वी कैन 2D सर्कल, वी हैव टू प्रोजेक्ट देम इन टू ए लाइन, 1D लाइन. To project projection means this projection will not affect the relative distance between the points. For example, it will not affect the relative distance between x1 and x2, x2 and x3, x3 and x4. However, we cannot maintain the same distance between x2 and x3, but relative distance will preserve at some extent. Here distance doesn't means the distance between x1 and x2 like that. Here we consider the arc distance like this. So this is the representation of points, and here in the form of circle, that how we can represent the points into less dimension. This is the corresponding projection of 3D hemisphere into 2D plane, 2D circle. This is the projection of a points on the circle on a line. This is a projection of 3D hemisphere into 2D circle. That's why by using similar way we can apply the projection technique to reduce the dimension. Now the Rokio text classification, how it works. First, the term is relevance feedback. Two class, relevance versus non-relevance document. Methods can be adapted for text classification. Means whether the documents are relevant for that class or not relevant for that class. We can use Rokio text classification, use TF-IDF weighted vectors to represent the text documents. For training in each category, it computes the prototype vector by summing the vectors of the training documents in a category. Finally, it calculates the centroid and then assign a new text documents to the category with the closest prototype vector based on the cosine similarity. Now first we will go how it works. Suppose in this set of documents, first we will learn what is the cosine similarity. Basically cosine similarity measure is used in calculation of similarity between two documents. Here we will go through some very simple example how it can calculate. For example, to calculate the cosine similarity between document D1 and query Q represented as angle theta 1, how can we calculate? This is a document D1 where 2 is suppose 2 is the TF-IDF vector score, TF-IDF score of term T1, 3 is the TF-IDF score of term T2, and 5 is TF-IDF score of term T3. Actually it is not TF-IDF score, it is just maybe representation frequency representation of terms, but it will work in the same way if we use the TF-IDF. Here query in query Q, number of term T1 is 0, number of term T2 is 0, but two terms matches with T3. So here Wij into Wiq, for I is equal to 1 to T, and similarly here Wij whole square into Wiq whole square. Wij into Wiq. Actually here Wij, here it will be W1, W2 and W3. And WI1, W1, I2, WI3, WQ1, W2, okay, sorry. Here WIJ, actually only one word, only one term match. So WIJ will be 5, which represents, which match with two terms of query Q. So here it will be 2. Now suppose here score is more than 0, like 4, then we can add some extra term, sorry, not here, earlier, like 3 into 4, like that. So but here not it is so, because here it is 0. Now the denominator part, we can Wij whole square means the term frequency scores whole square of all terms frequency. For example, here it will be 2 square plus 3 square plus 5 square into WIQ whole square, as it is 0, 0 and only 2. So 0 square plus 0 square plus 2 square and whole root. This will be equivalent to this, and this is equivalent to this. After that we will get this calculation result. Now suppose here we use 4 instead of 0, then we'll make some change, like here 4 is square, and here we will include this part also. So after that ...22 divided by some other amount, like 4 plus 9 plus 25 whole square into 16 plus 4, and after calculation we can get this angle. So this is the general trend to calculate the angle. By using same way we can calculate the cosine angle between two documents, and so on. Now how to apply the Rocchio classifier. Now suppose this is a red document, red circle represents the document government, blue circles represents the document science, and black circle represents the document art. What we will do, we will calculate the cosine angle of all the documents with respect to itself, and then calculate the centroid of that cosine angle. Similarly, we will calculate the Similarly, we will calculate, suppose this is a cosine angle. Similarly, we will calculate the cosine angle and their centroid for all blue documents. Similarly, we will calculate the cosine angle and centroid फॉर ऑल डॉक्यूमेंट्स रिप्रेजेंटेड एज ए ब्लैक कलर. एंड आफ्टर दैट सपोज न्यू डॉक्यूमेंट्स कम फॉर एग्जाम्पल दिस, देन वी विल कैलकुलेट द कोसाइन ऑफ एंगल बिटवीन दिस सेंट्रोइड एंड दिस डॉक्यूमेंट. इफ सिमिलरली वी विल कैलकुलेट द कोसाइन ऑफ एंगल विथ दिस सेंट्रोइड एंड दिस डॉक्यूमेंट. सिमिलरली कोसाइन ऑफ एंगल विथ दिस डॉक्यूमेंट विथ दिस सेंट्रोइड एंड चेक विच वन इज द शॉर्टर. देन वी विल डिसाइड दैट द डॉक्यूमेंट विल बी मोर सिमिलर टू द दैट शॉर्टर दैट डॉक्यूमेंट्स सेट्स फॉर विच द कोसाइन एंगल इज द शॉर्टेस्ट. हेयर इट इज मोस्ट सिमिलर टू द रेड डॉक्यूमेंट्स एज इट इज डिपिक्टेड हेयर. नाउ इट विल क्लियर फ्रॉम दिस एग्जाम्पल ऑल्सो. फॉर एग्जाम्पल दिस वेक्टर कॉल्ड प्रोटोटाइप वेक्टर represents the red documents. Red prototype vector represents the red documents. Blue prototype vectors represents blue documents. This is the centroid for all prototype vectors. For that what we will do, we calculate the sum of angle of all red prototype vectors, then calculate the centroid. I use the same method to calculate the centroid for blue vector. Now suppose a new document came represented as a black vector, then we will calculate the cosine of angle with respect to red centroid and with respect to blue centroid of the blue vectors. Now as it is smaller, so this black document will be the documents represented as a black vector will be the part of blue document set. Now this is the training phase is same. Suppose we have given set of categories and n is the total number of documents. This is the initial prototype vector, and for each training example where x represents the document and cx represents the class for which the document document belongs to, and let d be the frequency normalized TF IDF term vector score for document x. Here frequency normalized TF IDF score means we normalize the TF IDF score in each document by dividing the entire term frequency of every term in documents by total number of terms in that document to normalize that data into the form of 0 to 1. Now let I is equal to j while cj is equal to cx. Now we will calculate the proximity vector sum, and then we use this to calculate the centroid, and we use this centroid related information in classification of next document in the case of test phase. For any given document, test document x, for here let d be the TF IDF weighted term vector of given document x, then what we will do, we will calculate the cosine similarity of given document d with PI, and if it fixes some threshold or class level, then we will put that document into the given class and update the most similar class prototype. But there are some problem. Just reread this line. Here we update the most similar class prototype, which are the main cause of problem. Here prototype models have problem with polymorphic or disjunctive categories. For example, here documents are not clusters are not contiguous or classes are not contiguous. For For example, here right side you will see some red documents. Sorry, left side you see some red documents. Right side again see some red documents. In between there are some blue documents. So in case of classification, it may create problem. See how? Now suppose this is red, centroid of all red documents. This is centroid of all blue documents. Now this is black document. These are the angles with blue document and red document. And this black document shows more similarity with respect to red document centroid. While it is more similar to, in practical it is more similar to that blue documents. But due to the centroid concepts, it shows more similarity with red documents. So it creates some anomaly in final classification. Some properties of Rocchio classification. Actually, the boundary between two classes in Rocchio classification is the set of points with equal distance from two centroid. For example, this is a centroid represented as star, as a rectangle, and as a cross. Now A1 shows the distance from centroid with the document set represented by rectangle. A2 represents the distance of class boundary from the centroid, which contains the classes which contains the document sets represented by cross. Here A1 will be same as A2, B1 will be same as B2, and similarly C1 will be same as C2. This type of representation is generally called as Voronoi diagram. The generalization of m-dimensional space. We can generalize m-dimensional space through this equation W to the power T x is equal to B. Here, for example, for two-dimensional plane, we can write the equation like W1 x1 plus W2 x2 is equal to B. For three-dimensional plane, we can write W1 x1, W2 x2, W3 x3 is equal to B, and so on. The boundaries of class region in Rocchio classification are hyperplane. The classification rule in Rocchio is to classify the points according to the region it falls into. Some important points in Rocchio classification. Rocchio form a simple representation for each class, the centroid prototype. Classification is based on the similarity to the distance, similarity to or distance from the. Here we have seen the examples on similarity based on cosine similarity, but we can use the distance based measure. For example, we can use Euclidean distance or Manhattan distance to calculate the distances. It doesn't guarantee that classification are consistent with the given training data. We already seen some anomalies with Rocchio text classification. It is a little used in outside the text classification. It has been quite effective for text classification, but generally worse than NAB-based classification. But the main thing is it is very cheap to train the and test the documents. For example, we just need to calculate the centroid of documents. And there is very simple, that's why the training phase is very simple. And we can easily classify the documents. Thanks.